I am Mo Tuzano, the Tabletop Bellhop, your cardboard concierge, working with you to make your game nights better. What I'm here to do for you tonight is to let you know if you should be hyped about or interested in Ahau, Rulers of Yucatán. Now, this one comes from Aperion Games, and it has been localized by Grand Gamers Guild. Now, Grand Gamers Guild does happen to be the current sponsor of the Tabletop Bellhop Gaming Podcast, and I do have to thank Mark for hooking us up with a review copy of Ahau, Rulers of the Yucatán. Now, this is a heavier Eurogame worker placement, set collection, bidding, lots of stuff going on. This is not going to be a game teach. I have not played Ahau yet. I have not even read the rules for Ahau. I just did a quick look to find out what some of the components are. There's some great looking components in this game, including some awesome looking wooden resources and like giant standees that are going to move around your board and stuff like that. I'm really looking forward to checking the game out. But step one is to cut the shrink. So we're going to do that. And then we're going to take a look inside the box. I have the box for Ahau, Rulers of Yucatán from Aperion Games. I'm going to give a quick look at the sides. Not a lot going on here. And the back. Now that, definitely, I see that and I think Euro, and I don't think that's going to mislead us at all. But we're about to see all of this inside the box. This is a heavy game in more ways than one. The game weight is up there. It is almost a 4 on BoardGameGeek, but also physically, I have a feeling we're going to be seeing a lot of cardboard here. So we start off with... That is very cool. The historical background for the game. That is awesome. I really appreciate this. Look at this. It's going on about the various cities. Oh, the roads, the awe-inspiring buildings. This is fantastic. I love this. This is really cool. And then the legendary rulers. I thought it said rules for a minute. So yeah, it's got the different roles. Oh, this is really cool to see. Props to the company for including this. And then the list of the various gods. Aperion, props for giving me some education with my board game. I do appreciate that. Could have very easily just been a pasted-on theme. It's nice to see it's not. Then we get the rule book. I don't know why game designers have sworn that the rule book must be as big as the box. I hate these kind of big floppy. Like, how do you read this? Do you hold it like a newspaper? Anyway, let's take a look at it. I got to say, layout's nice. This component review looks great. They're showing even the backs of cards. I always appreciate that. We're going to have some nice 3D elements to see here. Then we have the layout and setup. Going to be a bit of a table hog, as you can tell from this. Text is fairly small, 3 columns. This one's going to take a bit of work. There are only actually 4 actions in the action phase, so... You know, just flip through this and kind of give a general idea of what the rules look like. And then we have the various building styles. So we got some summaries there and then the various role cards. So we're looking at 14 pages. This is, again, explaining icons. So where is like game end? End of the game. So 13 pages. That's not terrible, but these are pretty big pages. Then some reference info. Solo mode appreciated by many gamers the world over. Separate solar mode. I like that it's color-coded. The solo mode's got the blue edge. Looks like a detailed solo mode and a very nice summary on the back. Then we've got the board. Let's see if this board will fit on my camera. It may or may not. It's going to be awfully close. It is two-sided, as you can see. Oh, look at that. It's close enough. You get the idea. All you're missing down here is a scoring track. So you've got like your combat track here. You've got your phases. This is the, I'm pointing something you can't see, 3 or 4 player side, 2, 3, or 4 player side of the board. We can flip it and show the other side. You've got your map of the Yucatán broken up into different regions and then places you're going to put your temples and your resources and track your score and the buildings you're going to build. I got to say, it's a pretty striking board. I like how clear everything is for how busy it is. Like the spots, the information you need to see, like the borders. And the numbers are very clear, despite it being a very colorful board. And the other side features the same art. This is the 2-3 player side of the board. You'll note there's only 5 provinces now, or 5 regions. Always like it when you get a dual-sided board. Oh, we even have a box insert in here. So a ton of temple files that are literally just falling out. That's how well punched they are. A little thin. Holy cow. Okay. I'm worried I'm going to lose some of these. They're literally popping out. So you have temple tiles. They're two-sided. Some you're going to take out based on the player count. These are going to go in a bag. I expect to find somewhere in here, and you get to pull out temple tiles. You can trade these in for actions, but I got to say, I really dig that artwork. So we're going to just drop that in there. Hopefully there's some extra room to be able to fit these. Okay. These are the city tiles. These are going to be randomly placed out onto the board, and then we have a whole bunch more temple tiles. Again, oh my gosh. Wow. These are a tracker for how powerful your weapons are in the game. And then we have buildings and the standees. I can't believe how much this game's going to be punched by the time I'm done. It's also an unpunching. So there we have the leader tokens. They're going to send to the different regions. And these are the building tiles. And those are a bit busy. They're tiny and busy. I don't love those. For like from across the table, that might be a little hard to see. No, this is just me speculating because I have not played the game yet. And then you have the resource tokens that are between cities that you use to produce things. And then what we have here are these 3D pyramids. And what I'm hoping to do is build one of them. So we're going to pop this out because I wanted to be able to show this off. One base and one top. And out of that, we're gonna build a temple here just to kind of show them off. So make sure I'm bending this the right way. So one of the things you can do is you could just play with this side and you would put the appropriate token here, show that temple. If you don't want to go through the fuss of building this or the 3D, or you think it's easier for people to see, or I've seen on live streams, it's much clearer on the on that side because then you get the top down view. Do I have this turn the right way? Yes, I do. I'm not making this look easy. I'm sorry. It's because I have one stuck inside. So yeah, slightly annoying to build temples the first time you play. Okay, am I doing something wrong? Do I have them the wrong way? I may have. Okay, I think I had that the wrong way. Yes, so once you put them the right way around, they go together much easier. So there you have your temple, and then the bonus for that temple slots into the top and becomes the top of the temple. So everyone on the table can clearly see this temple gives that bonus. And yes, once I realized I had it sideways, things went together much better. Nice playing piece, adds some three dimensionality to your game board. I do not know if those will fit in the box once assembled because you do have five of them. Then we have stickers. Everyone loves stickers, right? So we have stickers that we will have to place on our workers. The round phase cards. These are actually a part of the key part of the game that you're going to draft them at the beginning because they do set your starting resources. And then the god powers. So a nice summary card, but very small text. That's going to be rough to read. I have bifocals. I don't know if you can see it. I got to go about half arm lengths. Okay. So there's an insert, but there's also a ton of space. Odd choice, odd manufacturing choice, silicone gel pack, unless you live somewhere very humid. If you do, keep it in your box. Otherwise toss that. Make sure you keep it away from kids. We have standee stands that just slid right down the edge. Didn't it? Okay, I don't even know what went flying there. Standee stands and a clear disc token. This is the round marker that is actually acrylic. So there's a nice little bonus upgrade here. So you actually get an acrylic round marker. Cards, not finding a quick release. All right. Different cards for the different gods. I'm not sure what that track's for. Then your bidding cards for each player color. These help you determine what region you're going to act in, as well as... Oh, no, that might be a solo play thing. I don't recognize those from what I know of the game. There are 1 to 6, should be in the different player colors, and it results in each different region. You're going to play two of these around. One's your combat strength, and the other is what region you are going to try to move your person to. So again, you have those in the various player colors, and the artwork does repeat to match the art on the board. Day and night sides of the individual player boards. Note the game is not asymmetric. You're going to choose to use either this side or this side. This might be the solo game one. So again, bad example there. So you're going to choose which side to use. The light side is the easier, you play this first kind of side. And look at all the wood. I'm looking forward to that bit. So we got a baggie. Your temple tiles are going to go in here. You're going to pull from. We got baggies that are not for gameplay, but for storing all this stuff. Nice, solid stack of those. Always appreciate when a publisher gives us baggies. And then you can tell there's a sorting tray here for the various tiles. Now I want to get into these wooden bits. And to do that, I am literally going to get this off the table for now, along with this. So we can look at these look to be the player meeples and scoring tokens and stuff like that. So I'm just going to make a mess here. So yes, you have your little, looks like a little hiker, walker, meeples in the different player colors, and then a number of discs for tracking various things. I do see red and green. Hopefully these colors are good for players who have color-based vision issues. I'm hoping they did the testing on that. Sometimes when you see red and green, it does concern me. I could not tell you myself. I apologize. Then we're going to get into the resource markers, which I've got to say, based on when I saw this game and seeing it, they're tiny. I was not expecting quite so tiny. I do like these little guys, though. All right, resource tokens. I am not going to remember what all these are. Brown is cacao. Yellow is corn. Black is obsidian. I think water and stone, ivory, maybe. Those are your resources. You can kind of see by the size of my hand, they are quite small. I am slightly surprised by how small these are, especially that obsidian shard. Those feel like they could have been bigger. They are uniquely shaped, which is nice. So getting back to that issue of color blindness and friendly, each resource has its own unique shape, which is fantastic because you can tell them apart by touch. Little smaller than I'd like. Those are some of the tiniest resources I've seen in a board game, but I do love that they're each unique. So here's all of that kind of tossed into the lid. We're going to transfer that back into here in some fashion. I'm sure there is a more logical way to do this than dump everything in wherever it fits. But that's what I'm going with for right now. We will punch and sort all of that later. You know what? I bet you the temples fit here. I bet you the built temples fit here. That would make a lot of sense. I kind of wish I'd left that one together to confirm that. So now we're going to see if I can build it a little quicker than last time and actually like try putting it together right side first. Oh, one's inside. It's a two-person job, or don't do it while you're live on camera job, because you don't have the coordination. Well, there. Okay, we're going to test it right now. Take this out. Yep, look at that. Bonus! I can't see why you wouldn't fit five across. All right, better designed insert than it looked. Bonus points. Well done. Well done. Sorry for doubting you. And once these are made, they're solid. Like, you know what? Let's do it. I'm not going to build them all, but I'm going to put it back in here with that there. Is the cardboard going to hurt that? No. Ugh. Damn it. Doesn't work. Doesn't work. You'd have to build them all. No, this is a streamer only problem. YouTuber only problem. Because everyone else would just build that right now. And it'd be fine. And you would build them all. And then everything would fit nice. Yeah, I got some of these turned a different way. and everything's punching out of them. Listen to that. There's just stuff falling out of these. This game wants to be punched right now. It wants me to pause and punch the entire game while you watch. I'm not doing it. It's a later day thing, not a right now thing. Mm-hmm. Oh, no. I can see a token. I think we're good. Mm-hmm. I probably didn't put that on the way it came off. There we have. Ahau, rulers of Yucatán. Oh, there it is. I did not put the lid on the right direction. Get to see what comes in the box. And Ahau, rulers of Yucatán. A lot of cardboard. Some pretty cool, slightly annoying to build temples. Nothing compared to removing the film off standees, though. So I can't fault them for much. A better design box insert than I thought. At first, it looked really silly to me. Then I realized it's so you can build those temples once. There's five of them. Build the five temples and just leave them set up in the box, which is actually fantastic. This looks like a meaty one. This looks like it's got some meat to it. Kind of game my wife's going to enjoy, I think. This looks like a meatier Euro with a lot of stuff going on, and I am really looking forward to diving into Ahau, Rulers of the Yucatán from Aperion Games, localized, brought to your local friendly local game store by Grand Gamers Guild. I can't wait to dive into this game. Like I said, I think my wife's really going to dig this one. Now, when we do play this, we will be sharing our thoughts on the Tabletop Bellhop Gaming Podcast, which you can find on your podcatcher of choice. I got dust off the thing and I just put it on my shirt. It's terrible. Look at that line. See? Last unboxing for now. All right. Thank you for joining me for this unboxing video. When we do get this played, we will be sharing our thoughts on social media, where you can find us on most of the major platforms as Tabletop Bellhop One Word. I'll be sharing pictures and images and talking about the game. We'll be talking about it on our podcast, the Tabletop Bellhop Gaming Podcast. And eventually, you'll see a review over at our website, tabletopbellhop.com, which I invite you to check out now, because we're done here. Good day and game on.